This is reposted.
We've tapped onto Simon Sinek a few times, and today we're going to look to him again for a tweet that he put out. He said, if you have the opportunity to do amazing things in your life, bring someone with you. I mean, that sounds like a nice thing. And I was kind of thinking about like people who just say it's lonely at the top. And I found this quote from Charlie Sheen that says, people say it's lonely at the top, but I sure like the view. And historically, things have not worked out well for Charlie Sheen. Further shoring up this Simon Sinek thing. Charlie Sheen is on Cameo right now, and he looks bad. So bring people with you. It's more enjoyable to share success rather than have people hate you.
Okay, so I am truly trying to figure out if this Simon Sinek quote is cheesy or not, because when I Googled the Simon Sinek quote, all I got was this. Listen to this. Lift as you climb. Shared experiences are better experiences. Always send the elevator back down if you get to the top. If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go with someone. So I'm trying to determine if Simon Sinek's quote is not on the cheesy Hallmark card side of things.
I mean, the part that you found was, I just think it's an opportunity that like, it's more fun to do for me. Maybe a super introverted person. I would be curious. I think your wife identifies as introverted, but do you think she would rather be successful and go sit in a treehouse and read a book, or have you sit next to her?
She's not that much of a loner.
Unabomber.
She's not the Unabomber, although sometimes. I think this quote comes, and here's another quote. If a tree falls in the forest and nobody's there to see it, did it fall in the first place? Like, if you make a memory, if you do something and no one else sees it, you can't share it. It almost is as if it didn't exist.
Yeah. I mean, if I don't put a TikTok video out, did I really do something?
That's a great analogy. But is he saying like, is he using this in the business context, like as in mentorships? Like you should always be looking to help the person that, no, he's not, you don't think so?
No, I think he is. I think it's applying to everything. It's in business. Like, I think it's better. This podcast is more fun doing it with you than it would be myself. I mean, some people, Bill Burr is successful in doing a podcast with no guests. And another experience that we shared together is we walked the Reno Strip at 3 a.m. Yes. If you did that by yourself, that wouldn't have been interesting. I mean,
you know, that's funny you say that, because I was trying to think of an analogy, but I think being a comedian would be one of those things where you really do that on your own. I'm sure there's comedians in the club with you, but that career, I'm assuming, would be sort of a lonely kind of journey, because you stand up on stage by yourself, go city to city by yourself. It would be lonely.
Yeah, it would be lonely. And I guess, again, it gets back to what your personality type is. I'm pretty extroverted. One of my first jobs out of college was a research assistant in a biology lab. And I was doing experiments on mice every day, and I didn't really interact with people. And the work was really interesting because I was directly utilizing my degree that I had just received, but there was no human interaction, and that sucked. And so like, while I was doing something that I thought was cool, I was alone, and that wasn't fun for me. And I think that's taxing. And if you do something that's isolating like that, I think it's important to try to spend time with other people.
You know, you get more than you receive. I'm assuming, I've never been a mentor to anybody, but I'm assuming you get a lot of satisfaction if you, in your career, kind of mentor someone and see them go on to bigger and brighter things.
What kind of relationship do you have with your kids?
Well, I mean, that's career-wise. They're still so little.
Yeah.
You know, I honestly really hope as it regards to my kids, I really hope they do everything on their own. Like, I watched the Tiger Woods documentary recently, and it was like Tiger's dad was a tyrant. Like, he was going to golf, and that was the only thing. He made him break up with girlfriends. He made him do nothing else in life. I really hope my sort of leadership thing is, hey, man, find what you're passionate. I'm going to just support you and do that. I never want to, like, pull someone along something. I don't want to support them, but never pull them.
Yeah, and I guess thinking about business, I'm bringing people with you, it doesn't necessarily have to be partnerships, but like Zappos, I can't remember the name of the founder of that company, but he recently passed away. One of his things was like unexpected positives. Like, if you ordered 3-day shipping, they would spontaneously, they would cover the cost for one day shipping. Or employee culture is really important. I think you look at tech and making sure people you work with are happy, like is rising tide raises all ships. And I think that kind of applies to this as well. It doesn't have to be a partnership. It just means making stuff better around you is going to make your life better.
And you hear about offices where it's very cutthroat, where everybody's looking out for themselves. You know, you only win if you cut that deal. And you're of collaborative offices, which is where I'd rather be, mm-hmm. where you're working together towards a goal, and it's a much more kind of cohesive spirit.
Yeah, I mean, I was working for a company during the 2008 crash. I don't even know what we call it. Do we call it 2008? Was it 06? It happened in 08. Anyway. The narrative I kept getting was, you're lucky to have a job. Like, don't ask for anything. I was commuting 60 miles each way. And I was like, everyone else has a gas card. Can you at least reimburse me for my gas? And they're like, well, you're lucky to have a job. You shouldn't be here. I quit pretty shortly after that. And that's just like, if you have the opportunity to do something, like bring people up, like even if someone is subordinate to you, or below you, you can raise them up. Or if someone's at a higher position than you, like, it doesn't have to be like things are better if you're nice. Be nice.
Be nice. I mean, is this like a legacy thing? Like, if you have someone along in your company, after you leave, they'll still be there. And, you know, we're talking about the Warriors now. They drafted a 19-year-old kid named James Wiseman. Draymond Green is just about at the end of his career, but he's really putting a lot into him because he wants to make a better. And I somehow think he's going to be like, this guy's going to be in the NBA 20 years from now, and I'm going to be out watching games. I want my legacy to live through him. And that's kind of a cool thing to think about, you and what you help leave behind.
Yeah. I like to think about if I get to the point where I'm wildly successful, I'd like to have people I care about around me versus sitting in my ivory tower all by myself.
Oh, I can't wait. Can I visit you in your ivory tower?
Like Uncle Scrooge. No, you're not invited to my ivory
tower.
Damn
it. Hey, Simon Sinek, the best thing you need to know about Simon Sinek, he was born 6 days before me. 6 days before me.
Well, he really took his opportunity to deal with that. You know, 97% of matter was created after the Big Bang in the first 3 minutes. Simon Sinek did in those 6 days what you couldn't.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Well, if you want to look at the stars, please reach out. You can find us at Reposted Podcast on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. I'm Andrew Keller for Jeff Bezos, saying thanks for stopping by.